heard you got money. Oh, shit. Well, I ain't gonna talk about that ministry no more. Cause I'm kind of hurt for that, Jesus. But y'all know when you have to give something like this, the word hits you first. The word hit me first. It's okay. Y'all can survive. I promise you. You can survive. I'm still laughing at him. Cause he always gives me warnings. Can I tell you that I've been through hell and back? Okay. Can I tell you I had the biggest financial upset that we could ever have? Can I tell you where we lost everything that we had? Can I tell you we've been evicted 2 times, maybe 3? Look, after a while I stopped counting. I said, Lord, this here ain't what the profession we want to do. We don't want to be professional evictors. But you know, he lets you laugh at stuff like that. Because when he turns around and he blesses you. Don't get it twisted.
Okay.
Because you ain't fully right, don't mean that you get out of ministry. That means you stay there. You get the lessons that you need. And then you line up. And then you're standing on solid ground. Now you can walk in the ministry that God has placed you in. Now you can be an usher at the door, huh? And say, come on in and have a seat. Hallelujah. Then you can tell them, God bless you. Lost everything that we had, ain't had nothing to try, but the Lord blessed us. He says, I allowed you to see those things just so that I can give you an opportunity to see what your ministry is going to be like. Huh? Now I can laugh. Ministry, for the sake of the ministry, I had to go through those things. So I'm telling those who are in the specific ministry, if you feel like you're suffering from what you're serving in, you're suffering from what you're serving in. You're suffering from what you're serving in. It's only because you need to learn a lesson. Get your attitude right. Put the smile on you, but I don't care how bad it hurts. see it when it comes in the door in the vestibule, you can already rebuke it before it get to the door. I'm just saying.
Wow.
Okay, this here. The music department. Y'all stand up. The music department. Can I tell you I done shirt and all? Music department, the music means a lot. Now listen here, this is where. This is where a lot of churches, oh Lord, Jesus help me. This department is where a lot of churches let it fall to the side. Because you can do anything you want to do and sing on the choir. That's what they say. That's what some folks say. You can do anything you want to do and sing on the choir. No, you can't. Ask Lucifer. No, he can't. Made me wipe off my lipstick. Don't worry about it, I got some in my pocket. This here ministry right here breaks up the fallow grounds of the people's hearts.
Amen.
You fallow ground, you get it ready, you get it right.
Yeah.
So that you can receive the word.
Right.
So when you come to choir rehearsal and you think you just gonna woo, 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 and then you gonna sing right on Sunday, no? Can I see? Oh Lord Jesus.
Go ahead.
No. Okay. Can I see the hand of the leader of the choir and the praise team?
Praise
team too? Lord Jesus. You make that? There you go. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Okay, I'm gonna deal with the choir. Listen here, baby. After this year, you may not have no more choir members. Don't worry about it. I'm going to leave you my number. And if I can get here, I'll come. And I'll sing on the choir at the pastor let me. But listen here. I'm talking from president to president. I've been the president, I've been the secretary, I've been the singer, I tried to be the drummer and the organist, but it didn't work out for me. But listen here, as the president, honey, you can't let them tell you any and everything and it fly, okay? This here is a ministry, and the devil don't be playing. This is the devil's favorite part right here, and he understands if he can jack up the music, because let me tell you something. Sometimes the only thing that people are going to hear is the music.
Come on.
Music moves everybody.
Yeah, I know that's right.
They came just so they can hear the music, but what happens is, if the songs and everything is just this, just disco Bible, it ain't nothing right. You ain't hearing not one note. You don't jack them up because they don't want to hear the word. Everybody ain't came for the word. I'm sorry. Church is full, but half of them don't want to hear the word. They just want to hear the music. And then the other half just want to see who in church. So you leave with about 20 good members who want to hear the word. Okay, y'all bad. I don't care. But you got to make sure it's tight. Any and everybody can't sing on the choir. Get the mic right. I learned this shit the hard way. Yes, I learned the hard way. You can't be out in the world and come and try to sing under the anointing. Nobody. with the devil because the devil didn't play with me. When he was on my back, he rode me. You hear me? He almost made me want to kill myself. And when I say I was listening to TD Jackson, he told me, you go in there, you take all of those pills. And they look good to me because I couldn't handle the pressure of what was going on. But he made one mistake. He shut his mouth and gave the Lord a chance to speak. And when I heard him, hallelujah, thus I am today. So this here, why, baby? Everybody can't sing. So if you need to revamp, gone, DeeDee number two. Yeah, I like that. Don't be scared. You gotta do what you gotta do. Because people sitting in church dying because we don't wanna hurt nobody's feelings. But we all up in the way. So we'll get out of the way. Okay. Praise and worship. That's you? Y'all can go ahead and sit down. You sing by yourself? You sing by yourself? Okay.
They help me.
They help you? Okay, this year is what I want to tell you. Keep on doing it. Keep on doing it.
Come on.
Thank you.
Along with the praise and worship leader. You might be by yourself because ain't nobody else ready for it.
Amen. Amen.
They can't handle you. The weight of the anointing.
You gotta tell it.
That a praise and worship leader need to have.
That's good.
Sometimes it get heavy for you. But he said, I'm going to equip you to do what you need to do. Just stand flat-footed and listen to me. Keep on saying.
Amen.